It was around 6:30 p.m. on the evening of January 11, 1966, when Wanaque patrolman Joseph Sisko received a call on his police radio reporting a glowing light, or possibly a fire. The dispatcher also stated that people in Oakland, Ringwood, Patterson, Totowa, and Butler had claimed that there was a flying saucer over the Wanaque Reservoir. When Sisko located the source of the light, he stated that it looked bigger than any of the other stars, about the size of a softball or volleyball. It was a pulsating white stationary light changing to red, and that there was no noise. At around the same time, Wanaque Mayor Harry T. Wolf heard reports of the sighting and decided to travel to the Raymond Dam with Councilman Arthur Barton and Warren Hagstrom, and the mayor's 14-year-old son, Billy, who reported that the object was like a huge star. It was just a continuous light that changed from white to red to green and back to white. Soon after Sisko arrived at the scene, his radio started going bananas, with calls reporting the light from all over a 20-mile radius, including a call saying, "Something's burning a hole in the ice. Something with a bright light on it, going up and down. Oh boy, something just landed in front of the dam." At this point, Officer Sisko, Mayor Wolf, and the councilman climbed to the top of the dam to get a better look, where they would soon be met by many curious residents who had heard about the strange light and wanted to get a closer look for themselves. They all stood watching the light for about a half hour. Then, suddenly, it sped off to the southeast. Officer Sisko saw the light once more at about 4 a.m., moving south along the horizon. When he returned home to his wife, she told him that she had also seen something in the sky the previous night that she described as a silver, cigar-shaped object, which moved south from their home about 1,000 feet from the reservoir. A similarly described object was sighted by several officers on the day of the 12th as well, and based on these sightings, radar was installed on top of the dam to detect any future events. The object returned again in October of the same year, causing similar excitement among the community, but it hasn't appeared since and is yet to be identified. Stewart Air Force Base initially reported shortly after the first sighting that they had been flying a helicopter with a powerful beacon at the time of the sighting, but later denied that this helicopter mission had happened. McGuire Air Force Base claimed it to be a weather balloon, but soon retracted that statement as well. Both bases denied having any interest in the UFO, but two jets were reported to have flown over the reservoir shortly after the first sighting, and Officer Sisko reported seeing helicopters in the sky on that night as well. So, was this a secret military aircraft in the sky over the Wanaque Reservoir? Or was the military observing a mysterious craft that wasn't one of their own? Was this a hoax, or somehow a mass delusion? For now, the explanation of the sightings over the Wanaque Reservoir remain a mystery. If you'd like to learn more about UFOs and other mysteries, I've included links below to videos and other resources. And if you like what I'm doing here and want to support me, please like, subscribe, and share on your social platform of choice. I post new, bite-sized videos daily about mysteries, cryptids, aliens, and all things strange to kick off your day. See you tomorrow.